first wasps of the summer. Yeah, and there, and there's a lot of them around. So I need to do something about this. The time has come. Hi everyone. This blog is going to be about wasps. Wasps, who are everybody's favourite pantomime villain. Nobody likes wasps, and I've often heard it said, what use are they? What do they actually do? Well, it turns out that wasps actually are pollinators. Maybe not the greatest ones in the world, but they are included in pollinator lists. And the other thing they do is to eat garden pests, bugs and that sort of thing. So they have two useful functions, but that's not enough, I'm afraid. Nobody likes them. And much is made of the way they sting people and how they do it regularly and how they seem to enjoy it. Now, I think that is just anthropomorphic rubbish. But the stinging things is perhaps a bit interesting. Honeybees, as everybody knows, die when they sting you. And the reason they do that, happens, is because their stinger has little grooves on it, and they're like barbs on a fishing hook. So when their stinger goes into their prey or whatever they're stinging, then that stinger goes in and doesn't come out again. So what will happen is when that bee tries to sort of extricate itself, it just finishes up pulling its guts out and dying. Wasps, on the other hand, have a completely straight stinger, like a little needle, and so they can sting more than once. Now, if you think about it, that's what you'd expect, because wasps are predators. They prey on insects and bugs. And so they use the stinger, obviously, to kill these bugs. And if they stung something and then died, that wouldn't be a smart move, would it, really? So they're doing what wasps do. And now, from a beekeeper's point of view, wasps do present something of a problem. Is that, and that's because about this time of year, the nurse wasps are starving. During the beginning of the season, the young wasps that they're looking after produce a sugary liquid which the nurse wasps drink, because their waist, unlike mine, is very constricted and they don't eat solid food. Now, when the young wasps leave, the nurse wasps now have a problem, is that they don't have any food, and so they are starving. And so they get a bit grumpy, perhaps not unsurprisingly. Excuse me. So, where would wasps find a source of nice, sweet, sugary stuff? Beehives. So, beekeepers really should keep an eye on wasps, because they can attack and overwhelm a honey beehive. And it's happened to me. I'm sitting in Bumble in Ravenston, and over there, there was a hive which, when I had a look at it in the morning, there were a few more wasps around than I expected. And in the evening, when I came back again, they'd been completely overwhelmed and the colony was dead. And what wasps will do is that they sort of test a colony out to see how much they respond. Now, honeybees, some of the young bees, have a job of guarding the entrance to the hive, and so wasps will test them out and see, you know, how up for it they are. Now, in a very strong hive, then they will try and probably give up, but if they find a weak hive, they will keep on going and keep on going and keep on pushing till eventually they overwhelm them. And they're very persistent. Once they are sort of fixated on a hive, it is extremely difficult to get rid of them. And this is a little clip of what can happen with wasps. There's nothing I can do about this. They are dialed into this hive now, and if I leave it, they will quite probably kill it off. So, what is it we can do to try and deal with this problem? Now, there's two types really. There's the sort of mechanical type and there's the sort of trap type of solution. The first solution is to do something to the entrance of the hive to help the bees defend themselves. And the other thing you can do is put out wasp traps to try and keep the wasps down. So, firstly, what we'll do is we'll have a look at what I can do, what beekeepers can do to the hive to make it more wasp-proof. And then we'll have a look at how we make some traps. So, what can we do about the wasps? Well, the first thing we can do is to take the advice of the well-known beekeeper John Lennon, who said that we ought to give bees a chance. What do you mean peace? Anyway, we can give bees a chance by helping them to defend this area here, which is where the wasps will try and get in. If the wasps are very persistent, what I will do is put this little block in, and it's got the entrance there. So what has happened now is that instead of having to defend this whole area here, they just need to defend that area there, which hopefully will make life a bit easier for them. If however the wasps are very persistent, what I'll then do is just rotate this thing, and now there's a very small hole indeed, and push that back in, and now the bees have to defend that area, which basically means you can only get one bee in at a time. So that's one way we can help them, and the other way is by setting up wasp traps, and we'll have a look at that next. This is what is called a wasp bane, a commercially produced wasp trap, which is highly thought of in beekeeping circles. Now, I think they're expensive for what they are. They're 26, 27 quid, something like that. And at the end of the season, once you've used the thing, this, which is the bait chamber, is thrown away. And you have to buy a new one again. And I bought two recently for about 43 quid for two of them. So, a bit expensive. And I have used it once, and I wasn't overly impressed. However, we'll give it a go, and we'll put the thing together. So the trap consists of, this is sort of the main funnel, which goes this way around, and it's got some entrances in here, which is where the wasps go in. This is the bait chamber, and on top it's got a lid which you unscrew, and this goes on here, and it's got a loop there so you can hang it up. I'll do that in a minute. Now the bait chamber has got this stuff in it, which sort of looks like sugar but probably isn't, and he doesn't say on the container what it is. Now you also have this thing, which is like a little funnel which you push in to open the thing up. Try not to push it in all the way, so you can see there perhaps that the thing is now open. And what do we use? Well, our old friend, the amber liquid. And we use 400 mils, I think it is, of that, with an equal amount of water and 100 grams of honey. And also you have a packet here of activator. Now, I have no idea what's in there either. and it doesn't say so anything on the packet. So let's put this together. Once you've pushed this through, you open up this activator thing. Pour it in. It's a sort of a brown, looks like brown sugar. Doesn't smell of anything. And into there you put water. And the beer. And the honey. Take a little while, the honey's a bit thick. That'll do. Okay. Now, the main chamber of the thing, invert it. This actually pushes the plastic thing through into the container, like that. And then you just screw it in. That's it. And give it a good sloosh. And the top to it, which I've just put a little bit of string on, we'll go on here. Let's go down here. That's it. So if I can just get it a bit lower, thanks. It all, there we are, there it is in all its glory. So the next thing to do with this one, and also the other ones that we've made, is to put them in the apiary. And we'll do that next. If you don't want to buy a waspbane, a bit expensive, you can make your own, and it's a fairly simple thing to do. What do you need? An empty lemonade bottle. These are 2 litre size, and this is a Schweppes. You can use our whites, but I find that the Schweppes ones work more effectively. Next, some beer, lager rather, not beer. And again, it's cheap stuff, whatever you can get a hand on. This is Peroni. You also need some water, the same volume as the lager. Then some jam. Again, as with all these things, cheap as you like. This is essential blackcurrant. The mystery ingredient, which is prawns. Now, a friend of mine, Courtney, as well as being a beekeeper, he has his own pest control business, and he knows about wasps. And he has told me to put prawns in the mix. So I'll do what Courtney tells me. And finally, a little bit of Corex to act as a roof for the thing. That's 6 inches square, and also there's some string there to tie the thing up, hold the thing up. I use paracord, but string will do absolutely fine. So let's put the thing together. First thing, just take the label off it. And then you want to cut the top of it off, just about where the thing starts to curve in. You need to keep the top of it acts as a funnel for the wasps. So, there we are. We have a top and first thing, in goes the larder. And then the water. Prawns that are becoming very stinky. Ugh, horrible. And then I'm going to throw the rest of them away. So that gives you the basic trap. Mix it up a bit. What you need to do next is to make a handle for it. So you put a couple of holes in. Either side here, now I've already made the holes in the Corex, where is it, feed the string through if you can. Tie an overhand knot. And then, let's see, about this high, do another knot. That goes through the Corex, round the other side. Then, make a knot about the same size, the same place as you do on the other side. Oops. Sorry. Sit on the knot, feed it up through there. Put the paracord bow back down the other side. Leave an amount there to sort of hang it up by, then just do another overhand knot there, and that will go through this side. Tie a knot. Go up a little bit, so you can just muck around with the knots just to get it where you want it to go. Okay, so that's about right. I'll adjust that very slightly, but you can see then we've got a little roof on this thing now. This will stop the rain getting in and all flooding out, and then we have a trap. Now the last thing to do is to take the top that we cut off, and that take the top off it, and that just acts as a funnel. Now what happens is the wasps are attracted by the sweetness and the lager and the prawns, and they go down through the funnel through here, but they can't figure out a way of getting out again. Now honeybees can, it seems. And they're not very interested in this stuff, and I very, very rarely have got any honeybees in here. It's normally just wasps. and it might, it's occasionally flies and a few moths, that sort of thing, but it's primarily wasps. So now we just need to hang this thing up in the apiary, and that'll be the next thing we do. Now what I intend doing is having one of the posh wasp traps in each of the apiaries, here at Ravenstone, one down at Scald End, and to put a couple of the jam ones, the simple ones, down the other ends of the apiary. And there's one down there, and there's one down the far end as well, and also where Victoria, the British Queen, is, I'm also going to put one in there, although frankly she doesn't need any protection from the wasps. If anything, it's the other way around. So what we'll do, just as a final thing, we'll go and have a look at one of the jam traps that I put up a couple of days ago, and you can see what's happened in a fairly short period of time. Now this is the far end of the Ravenstone apiary, which is where the Warre hive is and my sadly defunct top bar hive is, and here is one of the jam feeders I put a couple of days ago. So if I just take the lid off and you have a look inside, so I think probably, can you see that? I'll just edge it away. Dozens of wasps, loads of them there. Yeah, so that seems to be working, and what I'm going to do in the interest of science is leave them till the season is over, and then have a look at each one and just to see how they've done, and perhaps compare the cheap ones like this with the expensive ones that we've just put out. Okay, thanks for watching.